Okay, we are live. I think we're live. Hello, goedemiddag, goedenavond, good evening, good afternoon, good morning, wherever you are. Welcome to Channel 48. My name is Puck. So today I want to talk about the BlackBerry OS. Yep, I know, but still I want to talk about it. Today I went to the MediaMarkt. Yep, I went to the MediaMarkt. I went to the MediaMarkt to go and film some of these, how you call it, BlackBerry phones. So I went to my friend at the phone shop at MediaMarkt. I say, hey bro, how you doing? One love. I say, today I want to film the BlackBerry phones because I never filmed BlackBerry ever. And I don't know why I never did that. He said, well, you never did that because we don't sell BlackBerry. I say, you don't sell BlackBerry? He said, no. I said, oh, okay. And then I was kind of a little bit disappointed because I was walking with my BlackBerry today. I made a nice video that is coming up. It's about a drive that we gonna do in this video. And we drive to the city and I film with the BlackBerry. And you know what? The files, they look fantastic and they are not so very big. So that is also kind of cool. They are not like them huge files, such as with my iPhone. You know, when I film with the full HD cam of my iPhone, it's like huge files. So I was walking with my BlackBerry and I was like, I'm the only person with a BlackBerry here at the MediaMarkt. He said, probably you are. Hello, Mr. Marina, how are you doing? And hello, Bob, how are you doing? I'm getting your messages. I can't believe they are still sold anywhere. No, because I just spoke to somebody. Somebody contacted me on my Facebook, Mr. Job. And Job told me he seems to know way more about BlackBerry than me. So he kind of informed me and he told me, hello Ahmed, hello Bangladesh, one love, my brother. And in fact, he told me, he updated me, he said, Puck, well, BlackBerry is not making any phones anymore. They only do the software. So there is some Chinese company that is creating these phones. I said, oh, okay. So we start talking and I was getting an idea like, but hey, if BlackBerry is not really creating phones anymore, but only the software, could they not, for instance, license the software to Sony? Just saying something, you know, so you're gonna get phones with the BlackBerry OS. And then probably you're gonna get BlackBerry OS 11 and 12, etc. You know, support will be out there whenever, you know, this would happen. But then I asked this friend of mine, Job. I said, Job, but how about the hardware? Is it about the same processor? I mean, like, could you technically let BlackBerry OS, the RIM OS, could it run on a device that, you know, is kind of having the Android hardware? He said, yes, it could be. So that means, in fact, if BlackBerry doesn't want to create phones anymore and they want to stick to the software, that's what they are really good in, then probably they could license the BlackBerry RIM software to other companies. So Sony will say, hey, yo, you know what, we're gonna, our next phone will come with the RIM operating system, of course, with an Android app player built in. That is, I think, the goal. It was also the goal for Microsoft. You know, I'm still wearing their shirt. I still love this company. Eh? I love Microsoft. You know, I love my shirt as well. But Microsoft could also have probably, let's say if Microsoft phone would have an Android app player that you could install any market and download any Android app and run it on your Windows phone. Would Windows phone still be dead, or would Windows phone still go like really bad? I'm not sure. Because I know that the Windows phone lovers, they love their phone. So many people are also kind of a little bit disappointed that, you know, the Windows phone did not make it and is probably not gonna be created anymore. Microsoft has no intentions to create another Windows phone. But maybe if they had this app player, it's all, you know, I was so amazed when I saw that this phone had the Android app player, that I could get my NPO. Check this. NPO just updated their app. I told you about that yesterday, right? So I went into my room and I picked out my own NPO, you know, the one that I modded a bit for iOS, for our iOS ROMs. And this is NPO. It's loading at this moment. It's loading via the app player. And there we are. NPO is, yeah, I have my screen very, very, very low, but I can show it to you. It plays fine. That while the new version will tell me, yes, you must upgrade, you must have whatever installed Google Play services. But for this version, I don't need it, and it plays fine. It loads a little bit longer. It takes a little bit, a second, you know, to load, but when it plays fine. There it is. Is dat? Gemiste programma's wanneer ik jou uitkomt. In full screen. Start live televisie waar je maar wilt. Of start een avond binge watchen. You see that? So, but they updated the app, and in fact we cannot use the app anymore, because the app is not running anymore on our not having Google Play service phone. So that is kind of a pity. But you can see we still have the old version. So if you still need it, I will have it and keep it until it stops working. Because these guys are good in that as well, to have apps out there that don't work. I hope that NPO will do a better job if it comes up to that. But really, I think that phones that could be sold cheap with the RIM OS, you know, would surely make the difference in 2018, especially for those that love their privacy and security, people that don't want to get hacked easily. You know, I think these people should, you know, be on the RIM OS. That's just how it is. And I've been looking even further to find me articles that, you know, are saying that the RIM OS was hacked, or that something happened, and I couldn't find any of that. So I found it very interesting to see that in fact the RIM OS could run on Android phones. Not on any Android phone, it will have to be modified, but it could. It is possible. And it's possible to then have a safe phone, a phone that will give you a lot of privacy, under 100 euros. The answer... No, I wouldn't buy a BlackBerry. I think they are a brand that is slowly disappearing. I remember a couple of years ago, people were dying to get BlackBerry. Okay, that is, maybe you are very right, Obima, but I still think that now in 2018, things kind of changed a bit. And people got to know even more about their phones and what their phones are all doing. So this is just about the operating system. You don't have to get a BlackBerry. You can get a Samsung. If Samsung can license RIM, then you can choose out of a Samsung phone that runs on RIM and that has an Android app player built in. Or you can choose for the Samsung that runs Android fully, you know, Android and nothing more than Android. But it's nice to have a choice, because at this point we have no choice. It's the same thing if I go to the MediaMarkt and I want to buy a laptop. You have two laptops there. One runs Mac, Apple, and the other runs Windows. You cannot go and say, I want a laptop with Ubuntu or Linux Mint. That while these guys, they do exist. It's not like they don't exist. Alessio, my friend, bonjour. How are you doing, my Jamaican brother from another mother? Boom, boom, boom. Yes, we're talking, in fact, about something that does not exist and will probably never happen, but it could happen. I mean, we are free thinkers and we are allowed to think free. Hello, Zakaria. How are you, my friend? Welcome all to the room and sit back, relax. We are talking about a second operating system for phones that you can choose out. We only have iOS and Android. And probably some Windows phones are still there. That's all we have now. BlackBerry is not being sold anymore because BlackBerry is not making any phones. They are only concentrating on software. So if they can also license the software of, you know, I think like if there would be a phone out there and you would learn out of the study that you make about the operating system, that it will be one of the safest, probably one of the safest phones out there, under 100 euros, about for 100 euros, would you buy that phone? Let's say you're gonna get the Puck phone. Let's say me, some millionaire say, Puck, I like you, we're gonna make phone, we're gonna call it the Puck phone, and it's gonna run RIM OS 11. Let's say, just imagine. And that phone will be sold for 100 euros. And it's the safest phone out there, beside all these other phones, from a couple of hundred euros a piece. Some of them being sold even with outdated software, until the day of today. We still have devices being sold as brand new in the store, running KitKat. And they do as if it's the normal, most normal thing in the world that it's running KitKat. This good tablet, it runs KitKat, you know. I'd buy it, but not as a daily driver. I think I would buy it for my daily driver. Yes, of course. And I would have my second phone in my pocket, because we have so many phones these days, that to do whatever I cannot do with my RIM. But thanks to the Android app player, probably I can do everything with my RIM phone. At this moment, I could not find anything that I could not really do with this phone. I edited a video of 22 minutes recorded with this phone, with this BlackBerry phone, under 16 minutes. I made a video about it. I did not post it yet. I was like, you know, let me wait a bit. But 22 minutes HD video being rendered into one, yeah, under 16 minutes with this phone. So if these other phone makers are gonna make some hardware with a lot of, you know, cores and lots of RAM, these things that we have these days, then you can end up with a fantastic phone. And you don't have to really pay for the name. You know, you don't pay for the name BlackBerry anymore. You just pay for whatever that guy is asking for his phone. If the phone will be, you will have models from 100 euros, starting at 100 euros. And if some European community or some big organization say, hey, we like that phone. We want this phone for our employees. We want these phones because we want our data to be safe. Then I think that all these other phones are gonna have a problem. Samsung and you know, the other operating systems, even Apple. Because Apple is nice, I'm also using Apple, I love my Apple, but Apple is also kind of tricky. You know, the developers there at Apple, they are very confused if it comes to the word copy and move. These are two programming words that make a whole lot of difference. Didn't Samsung used to have some? Yes, they had some. What did they have again? They have this other operating system, Badu, something like that, Badu Bada. So, in fact, Apple is. I love Apple, it's my company as well, but they are also doing tricky things. Now they're gonna come with an update that will disable the CPU throttler. But the CPU throttler in the first place, yeah, you know, and just like with the 4S, when it got really slow, that it was unusable anymore. You like them? Yeah, they are nice. If you never had one, you should have an iPhone to understand what the iPhone can do for you. You should have an Android phone to know what the Android phone can do for you. And you should also have a BlackBerry to understand what a BlackBerry phone can do for you. I also had a Windows phone. You know, I haven't had an iPhone. Well, you can get the iPhone really easy now. If you go to the marketplace, marktplaats.nl in my country, you can find an Apple really cheap. For 20 euros, you will have an Apple already. Yeah, Apple told me that my Mac is too old. No more update. I'm like, what the bloody hell? And these are the things that we find with Apple. Look, you guys, let's be honest. Apple was not created for you and me. We are just poor bastards. Who are we? The only reason that a guy like me bought the Apple was because there was some guy out there on Marketplace, you know, that sold me one second hand, fully, you know, some old device. That's how I started with Apple. My MacBook Pro that I have here, 2010. Yeah, what can I say about it? It runs on Mavericks. I think that the Safari is stocking up many times. I don't know. It's like you are being forced to go to higher builds. And yeah, I don't like that pushing around anymore. I'm tired of it. You know, I'm tired. That's why I'm on old devices. I don't want new devices. I love my old devices. I have a Dell here, dual core, running Linux. I have there an old, 2 gigahertz machine. Runs Windows 7 Professional, just fine. You know, I have an old Mac here in front of me, just fine. But sometimes I hate the things that it's asking from me. My iPhone, I stopped updating it at 9.3.1. I never updated it anymore. And I was glad that I never did, because everybody's complaining that their phone got slow. So yeah, I don't know. Yeah. So we have Apple, Samsung with the Android. We have this Bada thing. I don't know if it's still out there. And we have Windows Phone. Windows Phone is almost dead. You know, my favorite brother there at Windows, that works at Windows, said in a video, he said, well, me myself, I'm on an Android phone again. That I already said in a previous video, that kind of hurted me when I saw that, because, yeah, it's painful. I think if you sell a device, you know, you want at least to be on that device. If you're working for Microsoft, you don't want to have an Apple phone, right? You want a Microsoft phone. Or do I see it wrong? Maybe you should have all the three. I think if you work at Microsoft, you should have all the three of them. You know, so you can switch and don't hurt anyone. But the idea of RIM licensing their software to other phone companies could be a goal to get a safe phone. Purism needed $1.5 million to get started, but there are already so many, how you say that, it is overbevolk, how you say that in English, there are so many phone sellers. The market is flooded. It's flooded, and companies are getting in trouble because of that. Too much of the same. There is no company that is selling something different that we already have. Overbevolkt. Yeah, Zakaria. Sometimes it's hard for me to find the right English words, and I cannot think too long because we are live. I must find the right answers, otherwise the watchers will think, what who is this guy? What is he? You know, maybe they are already thinking that about me. But whatever you think, still, welcome to the chat room. If you enter this room, leave a like before you're gonna leave, you know, so we get some nice responses from you as well. Not that we are doing it for the likes, we are disabling the likes, but it's nice if we, you know, see them go up while we're doing the show. I like what OnePlus did a couple of years ago. What did they do? Tell me about it. And I'm reading here really fast in the chat. I feel the same way, Pugbro. That is my friend Bob, also your host and moderator, together with Alicio. I would buy a RIM phone. I would. If it was cheap and it was safe, and suddenly I would hear that even the police would start using these kinds of phones, and you can buy them starting from 100 euros, I think then Android has a big problem, my friends. Especially if it's also gonna have Android built in. That is gonna get crazy. The people all probably want some phone that runs on RIM, but also has the power. Because these things have so many cores now, that if you're gonna, for instance, in a Samsung S7, if it would run on RIM, then 50% of the power that it has could be dedicated or could be sent to the Android part, to the emulator part. It's just like when you're gonna install an... what are we using again to... These virtual things that we use in Windows and in Linux to run another operating system in an operating system. I think it's called virtual something. Whenever you're gonna run that, if you don't have enough power in your machine, that Windows will be very slow, or that operating system that you... But if you have the power, enough power, you can send it to there and it will run virtual machine. Sorry for that. I couldn't find the word virtual machine I was talking about. Whenever you run some virtual machine and you cannot give it enough memory because the main machine does not have that memory available and the processor power, then that operating system is gonna be a little bit slow. But whenever it has enough power, Android is the best because it's open source. No, not open source is not always the best. Open source is not always the best. And you already have the best built in. You have it in an app player. It's not that you're living without it. You do have it. It's in your app player. So you're not living without Android. You have Android in your RIM phone. And that Android is really fast, faster than Android on some other phones. Because the phone that you're having is a good phone. It has enough memory and enough processor power. Because, you know, these days we have all these cores. 12 cores, 8 cores, I don't know how much cores. I don't know how much cameras. You know, others are coming with 4 cameras now. You know, these cores, memory, we have enough of it. But what are we doing with it? We can push it to another operating system that is built in the phone. In this case, it will be Android, because Android is the most popular operating system in the world. So if you're gonna create a RIM phone, it doesn't matter if it's gonna be a Sony RIM, or a Samsung RIM, or a Wico RIM phone. You know, if Wico can sell this beautiful phone. Today, I was at the Media Markt, and some guys were looking at the Wico. I said, this is a very good phone. But I had the idea that they saw the review somewhere, because they looked at me at a particular way. They didn't say anything about that, but I advised them to buy this Wico, and they bought it. They bought it. You know, the guy bought it, and he's probably now playing with it. And it would be an even better deal than the Motorola that was also being sold, but was running Android 6. That while this Wico has Android 7. Let's say if you could buy a phone like this, that runs RIM, but also Android. Which one would you buy? The one with only Android, or the one that is running RIM, the safest operating mobile operating system in the world, with Android built in? Or would you go only for Android? Let me know in the comments. What would you do? If you could buy some Samsung phone, yeah, that runs only Android, and you can buy the same phone that runs RIM, the safest operating system, mobile operating system in the world, but also has Android built in, so you have, in fact, a sort of how you say this. You have two operating systems in one. Which one would you go for? Of course, you would go for this, because you already have this. You would go for allebei. There you go. You would go for both, the one with the boat with two operating systems in it. So it is an idea for BlackBerry to come back, because they are needed in these times, you know. We have lots of problems with our privacy. People are getting hacked. Sometimes you see lots of spammings going on here on YouTube. These people have no Google two-step verification account. How many of you here in this chat room, yeah? Zakaria, this one is for all of you in the chat room. Tell me, how many of you have a two-step verification? That whenever you log in to your Google and you did not log in with that device yet, you must confirm with the code. You get an SMS from Google. How many of you have that? Please let me know, how many of you have two-step verification with your Gmail account? You have that. Zakaria has it. Who more? You have it. Two. That is two of the six. Who more? Bob, do you have it? Do you have two-step verification? Do you know what that is, Bob? Because if you don't have two-step verification, it means that everybody can log into your account whenever they know your password. And it's very important to have a two-step verification, because you're not dealing with a secure platform. The platform of RIM is so secure that if you're gonna start using it, you're probably not gonna use WhatsApp anymore. You're gonna use that chat service of them again. The ping thing, because it's one of the safest. These guys have been in security for over 30 years. There is no one, not one company, that has the same reputation if it comes to security than BlackBerry. So whoever is making BlackBerry phones now, and that is a Chinese company, they are creating the BlackBerry phones, and they have some very sophisticated models. BlackBerry is only doing the software. So I would love to see that if BlackBerry is only doing the software, that they will, just like Microsoft, how Microsoft licensed their Windows to Nokia, you know, that something like that is gonna happen with the BlackBerry OS. But then development must continue. And Mr. John Shen, that's the CEO of BlackBerry, he said, it's not impossible. It's gonna be a lot of work, but it's not impossible. So we just have to, you know, hope that somebody there at BlackBerry will get some bright idea. Hey, yes, we should like, hey, Sony, how are you? You know, these guys, they talk their own language when they call it. Yes, how are you doing? Listen, how about this RIM software of you guys? Can we not license it? And then probably they're gonna get together and talk about the hardware that is needed to get it, you know, fixed. And that's just how it goes on these levels. These guys, when they meet, these are multimillionaires. These guys, they have all the power to do whatever they want for the good that brings money to the company. So how can you get a massive public to buy your phone? I think it's just like selling eggs. If you have 12 eggs and you're gonna sell them for €1 a piece, you know, it will take longer than when you're gonna sell them for 50 cents a piece. So Kickstarter, I don't think these guys need Kickstarter. You and me need Kickstarter, but I'm not planning to do anything like that. I don't have the cash in the first place. If somebody, you know, will contact me and say, Puck, we like you, you're gonna be our chairman and we're gonna make the Puck phone and you're gonna sell it, then I will know how to sell it. Of course I will know, because at this time what I need is not an expensive device. I need a good device that looks good but is not expensive to make. It must have good hardware and it must have a good operating system. And it must make the users happy. Whenever the users are on it, they must be happy. They must have a video editor. They must have a good sound recorder. The thing should have a good microphone. So when they go to a concert and make video of their favorite band, it doesn't sound like... When they come home, they cannot even, you know, listen to the recording because the complete thing is messed up. That while the video is over beautiful, maybe in 4K, but the sound is crap. I don't want none of that. I want a phone that is A, safe to use, very safe, that you cannot hack easy. I mean, like, of course, everything is possible, but at this moment, too many things are possible. So that's why I think RIM, what they should do is license their BlackBerry operating system, phone operating system, to other phone companies. These can be new ones, these can be existing ones. This can be Sony, this can be Motorola, this can be Samsung. This can be any company that wants to sell their customers a phone that will protect their privacy. Not a phone that is out there to make money with the privacy of the people. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Did you hear the applause that I just got? That was worldwide applause I got by saying these words. So, whenever a phone company is gonna deliver a phone that will have A, privacy, 2, a good reputation, 3, good hardware, but you can choose because we have them starting at 100 euros, going up to 2,000 euros for the people that want Porsche design and have the money to buy it. Not that we're gonna create hundreds and thousands of those phones, because we want to get to the real public. But they all gonna have Android built in as well. So it's not like we're gonna ban. This is a cooperation. This is a cooperation between BlackBerry, Android, and the one that is gonna, you know, the one that is gonna create the phone and sell the phone and bring the phone to the public. And this could be any phone maker. But we need to have that Android in that RIM. It's not only about safety. It's also about fun. People want to play with their phone. They want to sit on the couch and put some iOS launcher. Look, I have iPhone or my BlackBerry. You see, people want to do crazy things with these phones. And we can do these things all in Android. So Android is giving the satisfaction to each and every user. Everybody, me, myself, you know, I'm not playing with my iPhone. My iPhone is only to work, to make videos and render videos, make phone calls, call mama, you know, but not to play games. I don't do these things with my iPhone. I only work. It works, you know, and this I play with, my Android phones. Because I understand them, I can make ROM for it, I can do this with it, I can, you know, make it nice, give it a theme, I can choose out of 100,000, I don't know, million apps that I can download from my APK store. But with BlackBerry, we only had BlackBerry, RIM OS, nothing more, nothing less. But now, we have Android built in. You know, only thing that I want to see now is BlackBerry OS with Android Nougat app player built in. Android 7.1.2. You know, look, I'm going to show you something. If I'm going to go to here. Oh, hold on. If I'm going to start up this. Yeah, this is not Apple operating system. This is just a theme. Okay. I'm gonna show you something. You see, now we have Apple look and feels. So if I'm gonna go to the settings in here, I'm gonna hit the settings. Then you're gonna see something. Look, you see, now you see Android settings. And if you go all the way down, this is now an Android phone. We are now in the Android part, you see. And if you're gonna go here, you're gonna see it's Android 4.3. And that was for 2013, was great, because this phone came out in 2013. And thanks to the Android 4.3, I'm so enthusiast. I'm seeing the light. It's like I met God. Because now I see what other phones are missing out. And that is the RIM OS as standard, basic, the upper OS, the God OS on the phone, on the mobile phone, any mobile phone out there, you know, but also Android built in. It's not that it's only RIM. No, it's RIM and Android. Android will not be excluded because this phone, even though it's so secure and it has blah, blah, if it has no Android, I don't want it. Probably. So, Mr. Sheng, listen to what I'm saying. This phone is only interesting because of it having Android built in. If it did not have the Android built in, it would not be interesting. Because then it would be kind of boring. Because in BlackBerry world, we don't find too much apps and some you must pay for. And I was looking for a BlackBerry card today to buy some apps. I couldn't find any. So I'm sticking to my Android apps. I'm just fine with all the apps that are in the RIM. Because in fact, they are more than enough. You even have a video editor. Those that they didn't know yet. This phone from 2013 can render 22 minutes of video, HD quality, under 16 minutes. I made a video last night. I made a film to see. You can also install KineMaster on it. But then, this is a dual core, this is a 2013 machine. Then, of course, KineMaster is very heavy, and then you're gonna see that it will have problems with, you know. So you're an idiot if you're gonna do it in KineMaster, because you also have your own story maker built in. Then you have to think something out how to make that film with the story maker. It will let you, you know, add as many videos and pictures that you want, and it will even let you add a little storyboard at the front and at the back of the video, so you can still make a decent video. You can even, you subscribed? Oh, you never subscribed yet? How did you know that I was live? So, you guys can make videos with this thing and make a decent little end production for your YouTube. And it will look fantastic. The sound of this thing is better than the sound of my iPhone. When I hear myself talking on here, recordings that I made, I'm like, wow, it sounds so clear, so nice. And with my iPhone, it sounds a little bit, you know? Oh, to Obina. Oh, to Obina. Yes, hey, Obina, I did never subscribe to you yet, bro. Hey, all of you, leave your links here and, you know, subscribe to each other, help each other out with growing, you know, because we must help each other to grow, because you are all my friends, and you know I got much love for you. So, I think it's a good idea. So that's what we're going to do, gentlemen. Can I have some votes? Will we create the BlackBerry Android phone, the RIM, the mobile phone that will run on RIM, OS 11, and of course the Android app player Nougat built in, and with 2 gigabytes of dedicated memory for the Android and 2 gigabytes for the BlackBerry, or maybe 3. How much gigabyte memory shall we put in that phone? 6 gigabytes to make it all crazy. We will also have to tell the developers from the show little app, the movie app, to update it, because we cannot add titles yet. So somebody there at Storymaker, go ahead and fix that. Hello, Sign. How are you? So, yeah, these are the only things that I see. Little updates and then a phone that will be on RIM and will have the latest Android app player available. And should it have Google Play Store? I think no, it should not have a Google Play Store. Because it should have an App Store of RIM itself, and not this app store that is already inside, what is it called? I always forget their name. Amazon. No, not Amazon App Store, but the App Store where you have some people working to test and retest, scan, and rescan every app that will be in that store. So you will have the RIM operating system will not only have an app player Nougat built in, but it will also have its own app store with developers that create Android apps, in fact, special for this app store only. And they will also get well paid for that. That's what I think. So they don't have to put in all sorts of advertisements. They get paid per app. They make an app and they get paid for that. So they can go ahead and create a next app and sell it again. If the RIM Commission likes it, they say, hey, it's a nice app, works nice. Oh, this beautiful app. We want it. How much, please? 250? Okay, good. We buy. I just give an example. I don't know how these things work, but, you know, I'm just giving an example. Or that, I don't know. I don't want to think about these things. I'm not a salesman. I'm just saying that this should be possible and it can be created and we can get safe phones in the future for even less money than we're paying now, because those phones that we are buying now are not so friendly. They are way too brutal and vrij postig, to say it in Dutch, and that is not so nice. Hello, Citech, how are you doing? How are you doing? Welcome to the room, my friends. So, listen, I want to say this. What I'm gonna do, because this broadcast is going too long and many people are entering. So those that just entered the room, welcome to channel 48. My name is Puck and I come from the Netherlands, Groningen. And today we are talking about how it would be if BlackBerry would license their software, their operating system for phones, to other companies, phone companies such as Sony, maybe Samsung, maybe Motorola, you know, name it, maybe Wyco. And then, of course, this operating system will also have Android built in. So this will not be only BlackBerry OS, no, not at all. It will be the main operating system of the phone will be BlackBerry OS, the Wyco, of course the Wyco, and it will have the Nougat app player, you know, the Nougat app player. What is an app player? Well, I didn't know it could be built into phones. I didn't know that it was possible, but BlackBerry, you know, this thing runs on BlackBerry OS, but it can also run Android. And now I'm switching over to an Android launcher that will even give this thing the looks of an Apple phone. Isn't that fantastic? That is thanks to the built-in Android of this BlackBerry phone. I didn't know that. I didn't know the Z10 could do a thing like that. I saw a BlackBerry on Marketplace and I was like, I never had a BlackBerry. It's so cheap. So I went specifications, you know, and I start reading. Can run and has Android built? I said, what? I want it. Call the guy. I say, hello. Yes, you can deliver the phone. He brought the phone for me. I give them something extra for the bringing of the phone. And that's how I got the phone. And since I have the phone, I'm like, this is the solution for mobile world to get back, gain back your privacy, gain back your, you know, all that hacking, all that stealing of your information, your data. You must always, you know, be all scared before you do anything, you know. Now it's not needed anymore. If we're going to get RIM OS 11, you know, and we're going to get the Nougat app player built in that also has its own security built in, you guys going to have the most fantastic phone in the world, probably for €100. Then you can go to the store and get yourself a RIM Android device. Yeah, the safest phone in the world for under maybe €100, starting at €100. That's possible these days. Because it uses the same hardware as an Android phone. So in fact, this what I'm saying is not impossible. This was told by me, by somebody that knows about these things. Because I didn't even know that BlackBerry was not making phones anymore. I thought they were still making, but on low scale. But it's a Chinese company that is making the phones, and BlackBerry is just giving the software to the company. So if that company can do it, why not more companies can do it? So we can, you know, heal the world. We should heal the world. It should be that if these guys could, it's not gonna be possible. Because BlackBerry is a locked system. So the bootloader will be locked. It will be a phone that you cannot root. You can forget about rooting. No rooting. If you want to do these things, you can do with Android. And Android is built in. So you can do everything that you wish with your Android. And probably you can even root it. But you're running BlackBerry OS. You are running one of the safest operating systems in the world. Am I? I'm not. I'm gonna take a sip of my coffee. I want to say cheers to everyone that entered the house. Welcome to the house. Much love. Sit back, relax. No big deal. I'm just a guy that loves phones. I love phones a lot. I love phones almost like I love women. You know? Every night I go with another phone to my bed. But these last days, I've been going to bed only with my BlackBerry phone. And I'm listening to it, and I'm playing with it. Oh, you're so nice. You know? No, so just letting you know, phones is my passion. Somebody asked me today, why you like phones so much? I said, because I understand them. And because I can bring some changes into them. And I can talk about them. And I have many people that also love phones. You know, so that's why I just love phones. And that's why I have so many of them. And I find it such a waste that they are all in some bag. And that once in a while I make a new ROM. And then I start all over again from the Gio to the Advance. And then the S2, the S2 Plus, the S3, the S4, the S5, the S... Oh no, S6 I don't have. I must still get S6. If you have an old S6, you can send it to me, please. It doesn't matter if the glass is broken. If it does works, then we can... put Lineage OS onto it and we can update the people. I also have the G3. A guy came to my room the other day on Christmas and he gave me a Christmas present. And in fact, yeah, I promised that I would buy the G3, the Samsung G3. And I found it exactly for that money as well. And I bought it and I showed it and we made the ROM. As a matter of fact, I made the ROM 2 weeks before I got the phone. I modded a ROM. And I trusted the developer that he, you know, didn't make any crazy mistakes and that everything would work. And damn, it worked. You know, 2 weeks later when I bought the phone, I downloaded my modded ROM, installed it, and the thing installed like a charm. I was like, wow, I put something out. I modded a ROM, a complete ROM for the G3. Of course, not developed by me, but I only did the modding. And I put it out, and these guys, they installed it. The video got 22 people happy, at least. And it was downloaded at least 100 times. So yeah, I find that good. I find that fantastic. So my next step now, our next ROM will be the BlackBerry OS 11 not existing mod ROM for all these phones that I just called for you in a row. So I hope you're gonna like it. I downloaded lots of icons yesterday. I went looking. I wanted to make a very colorful BlackBerry desktop. And I know the launcher that I'm gonna use. I got all the icons. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna one by one tonight, sitting on the couch, I'm gonna, you know, use one of my favorite launchers, and then I'm gonna give that launcher different icons. I'm gonna mod it from the inside and then test it and see how it works. I'm gonna make a nice boot animation. BlackBerry OS 11, you know, with the logo of BlackBerry. Something nice, black and white. So that's what I'm gonna make. It does not exist, but you know, when people gonna look for BlackBerry OS 11, RIM 11, they're gonna find my video. And that if they have an Android phone that was supported, they can install it, you know, and still trigger the company to continue with that with that operating system, because letting it die will be the biggest sin in the world. And to go for only an Android phone because, you know, your daughter wants to run Instagram, that is not enough reason, Mr. Chen. No. You must stay on the rim. As you said and apologized in the video, he said, Mr. Chen, John Chen, he said, but I wouldn't care too much about that, about the young people that are not interested in RIM. And then he apologized really fast. He said, I apologize for saying that. I didn't mean that, you know. So they also want to, you know, not make the young people feel bad. That's why the app player was built into the phone. And that's why we can run Android apps on our RIM, on our BlackBerry phone running 10.3.3. So, yeah, I think it's time to go to 11. And I think it's time to license the software to other phone companies so they can also deliver a phone that has pure look and has privacy, is safe to use and has its own good server and built-in chat and built-in video thingies and so, and built-in Android. That's all we wish and nothing more. I think that must become priority number one, to deliver a safe phone to the buyers. All phones are all Android or they are iOS. Poor Windows did not make it. Tja. But I'm saying what I'm saying. Yeah? If Windows would have dared to put in an app player, the Android app player in their phone, if they only had looked just a little bit at BlackBerry. But probably at that time when they were in the race, they were thinking, BlackBerry is already dying. We're not going to look at them. That while iPhone, Apple did look at BlackBerry. Let me show you something. You see, there is no button here. How to get in? Same thing like iPhone. You see, the same thing like iPhone. You just swipe up. And that's what is happening now in the iPhone 10. The thing has no bottom. You must do something like that with your finger. And that was from BlackBerry. BlackBerry had that first one in the world to have that. Yeah. So it's smart to also look at the one that is... What BlackBerry is this? This is the Z10... And this is just a launcher, and this is not how it looks. It looks like this. Like this it looks, you see? And the way it also deals with the launcher. To make a phone call, you cannot make a phone call from here. There's no phone here. This what you see here are all Android apps. You don't see anything here that has to do with BlackBerry. So this is a hybrid phone. But with BlackBerry as the main operating system. It's like you can see it as your router. You know, you have the internet and you have a router and your computers are connected to the router. The router is between you and the internet. That's how you can see BlackBerry. You are here in a safe environment, and out there Android is there. Nothing can happen to you. Android is playing there, but you are sitting here. So that's how it works. That's how you can kind of see it. So I like it. I like the idea. I like hybrid devices that can, you know, without restarting the device, immediately can go to the other operating system. I think it's fantastic. Sign said €65 for what? €65 for what? You will buy one? You like it? What BlackBerry is this? You can get even cheaper sign. Sign. You can get it cheaper. I bought this one for €15. I bought this one very cheap. The guy first asked €50 and then I said to him, no. I said this phone is not more than €15. His old phone, 2013. And then he said, yes, okay. So then he brought it. I say, if you bring it for me, I give you 25. And then he brought it for me. I gave him 25. I paid 25 for this phone. But if I would go and get it all the way in the middle of somewhere, I would also have to put 15 euros in my tank. So I made five euros profit. Probably his car used less fuel than mine. So you should not pay too expensive for the phone, but yeah, you should get a BlackBerry. You should. To understand what it is and to know how it feels and to understand what I'm trying to say in this video, you know, yes, you should experience it. And I really hope that the app player will be updated. I hope that there is no way to get into this Android, into this ROM. This is completely closed. We cannot go to XDA and say, can you please, you know, update the Android for us? Because that will not be possible. The complete operating system will have to be, yeah. We will need another app player in there. And to put that app player in there, you will need the code of BlackBerry. BlackBerry before I gave it to my cousin since she liked it. Yeah, I never loved BlackBerry because they were these small. I never loved these round small phones with all these buttons on it. I could never type these things. These were lady phones, huh? The Bold and the 96. I don't even know these, but these small ones, I never liked them. But this, I love this. And I also don't really like the thing that you pull out. They have a new one now, the key, I think it's called, and you can pull that out. And then you have a keyboard. For me, that is not necessary. You know, I don't have to type fast. I just type. Then I can think about what I'm typing. If you are typing too fast, you make mistake. And sometimes you say things that you don't mean, you know. So you must take your time to type these things. So that's why I don't need no keyboard. I just type. It's just fine. We must all take it a little bit easy in the world. And not fight things. And make sure that all mobile phones get a good operating system. One that will respect your privacy and one, but probably it will not be possible because maybe you're gonna get all these intelligence agencies that will say, no, 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 we don't want this to happen. No, 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 no. We now already have all the people on Android and now we can already see everything. And now you want to put all these people on closed phones? Are you out of your mind? We're gonna lock you up, boy. Huh? What do you think? I say, sir, I was talking about you. You must have good phone because your phone is also being hacked. So don't put it on me. I just try to get a good phone for you. That's all I would say. So I'm sure that not everybody's going to love the idea to make a safe phone. So probably it will not happen. Probably it will only happen for special. That's why these phones are so expensive. You cannot buy a BlackBerry phone like kind of cheap. You know, like only a second-hand one you can buy. But if you're going to buy these new ones, although these are Android phones, I don't want those on Android. I want one with BlackBerry OS. So probably then I will have to deal with the old one just like this, the Sept 10. So that will be it. Nothing more, nothing less. So I spoke more than enough. I'm tired of talking. So I want to say thank you for entering the room. Thank you for your time to listen to whatever I was fantasizing about again, as usual. But here on Channel 48, we have the freedom of dreaming and the freedom of thinking about things that does not exist and could exist with the will of, you know, those up there that have the power to do so. We can only motivate them and bring them some ideas. You know, sometimes these people, they also need a bright idea. And this is a bright idea. This is one of the brightest ideas of this last phone century time to get a good operating system together with a popular operating system on one phone. So, you know, all the phones can be even more protected and still have lots of functionality. So yeah, the user will not get bored on the phone and they will still be doing their things and all the things that they were already doing, but now in a more safe way and with more protection for their privacy. This was my video today, my live show. I want to thank you for joining in with me. I might go live soon on on my radio station, gonna play some music. I set it up my system even better today. So whenever you're gonna see that, please, guys, Obina Ik, please, you're also welcome to come to that room. So maybe Bob could, you know, put some link in here before I'm gonna leave. But we all gonna go to the other room. I'm gonna spin some music, some reggae music, and just chill, talk a bit with you out there. But I think this was long enough about RIM and Android on the future mobile phones. So once again, thank you for watching. Much love. Stay well. God bless. And till my next video. Bye bye.